Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends. In the last lecture, we have studied that what is the relation between the Gibbs free energy change and the cell potential. So now we are going to derive an equation in which there would be the relation between the Gibbs free energy change as well as the standard Gibbs free energy change. So let us see how we will derive it. So before writing the relation between the Gibbs free energy change and standard Gibbs free energy change, the first thing that we should know is what is Nernst equation that we have did already also. So let us represent it again. I would write it as E cell is equals to E naught cell minus 2.303 RT divided by NF into log of product divided by log of, that is log of product divided by the reactant, concentration of product divided by concentration of reactant. So in this case, I will not write as concentration of product and concentration of reactant. I will represent it by a common factor that we know already, that is known as equilibrium constant. So I'll represent it by K itself. So now the thing that we know according to the Gibbs free energy change relation with the cell potential, we know that, but delta G is nothing but minus NF of E cell, as we did in the last lecture. Similarly, delta G naught will be minus NF of E naught cell. So for this case, I could represent the E cell as, therefore, E cell will be nothing but minus delta G divided by NF, while that of E naught cell will be minus delta G naught divided by NF. So this two are the values of E cell as well as the E naught cell. So these two values we are going to substitute in our main equation of the Nernst equation. So let us see what is the answer that we could get, or what will be the final conclusion. So I am substituting the value of E cell over here as well as here also. So the answer would be, for E cell I could write it as minus delta G divided by NF, which is equals to minus delta G naught divided by NF minus of 2.303 RT divided by NF into log to the base 10 of chemical equilibrium constant, that is K. So in this thing, what I could do is I could take a common factor here as minus 1 upon NF, which will be delta G naught plus 2.303 RT log of K, while this will be the same as it is. So this two value will get cancel out each other. Now the thing that is left, and one more thing, that is minus also will cancel out each other. So now the thing that is left with me is delta G is equals to delta G naught plus 2.303 RT log to the base 10 of K. So ultimately now I could write the equation as in this manner also, that is delta G is equals to delta G naught plus 2.303 RT log to the base 10 of concentration of product divided by concentration of the reactants. So this is how we have represented the relation between the Gibbs free energy and the Gibbs free energy, standard Gibbs free energy change. So this is the relation. But there are also many much more factors in which if a chemical equilibrium constant is being maintained, or if the reaction is in equilibrium, then delta G will be zero if the reaction is in equilibrium. So for this case, the delta G will be zero, then delta G naught will be mentioned in this way. Therefore, delta G naught will be equals to minus 2.303 RT log to the base 10 of K. So this is how we could represent the relation between the Gibbs free energy and the standard Gibbs free energy. So, and this numericals will, this formula will also be very much influential in the numericals that we are going to do. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video, and yes, you have got an idea that how can we derive a relation between the Gibbs free energy and standard Gibbs free energy. So thank you so much, and share this video with your friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.